Now, Britain's Got Talent can make dreams come true, and somebody who's here with her own hopes and dreams is 14-year-old Olivia Archibald.
Hello there.
Hello.
Snug up on us there. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
What's your name?
It's your music.
Olivia.
Olivia.
My name's Olivia Archibald. I'm 14 years old. I live in Newtony Willows, and today I'm going to be singing. From the moment I wake up, I don't really think about anything else, but I just start singing and walking downstairs with singing, and then maybe sat in like a maths class thinking, wonder like in 5 years' time if I could be an actual star performing on the stage to millions of people.
Looking forward to it?
Yeah.
Bit nervy?
Given Olivia the support she needs backstage are her two sisters and her parents, who run a garage.
I think she's going to have to overcome the nerves, and if she does, I think then she'll show that, you know, she really can sing.
It's all yours.
Do well, Olivia.
Okay. Good luck.
What's your name?
Olivia Archibald.
And what have you come to do?
I've come to sing.
What are you going to sing?
In the Arms of the Angels.
OK.
Love that song.
All right, well, when you're ready.
Thank you.
Here we go.
It's a hard song to sing.
Spend all your time waiting.
Utterly spellbinding. I mean, you've got such a lovely quality to your voice, a very professional and confident performance. Well done.
Yeah, I think, Olivia, what I really like about you is I don't think you know how good you are. But you came on and you were very shy and very humble, and then you just sang utterly beautifully.
You're so nervous, Olivia. I mean, even now, you're shaking. We've had a lot of kid singers come out. When I say kid, I mean you're 14, young singers, taking on a song which is just way, way too big for them. You sang that so well, and you made it your version of the song. I am so, so impressed with you, Olivia, I can't tell you. Beers, yes or no?
Yes.
Amanda?
Yes, from me. Simon?
Three yeses.
Put Excited and a good mood. The audience were on their feet. That was fantastic. How'd you feel?
Fantastic.
Yeah? Well done. Congratulations.
You.
See well you done. In the next round.
Thank well done. You.
Brilliant.
What's your name?
Darcy Oak.
Darcy, where are you from?
I'm from Canada.
Are you living in the UK or are you?
I'm not, no, I came here just for this. So.
How old are you, Darcy?
I'm 26.
And what got you into the act that you're doing today?
When I was a kid, actually, I had hopes and dreams of becoming a doctor, but my parents insisted that I become a magician. So here I am. My name is Darcy Oak, I'm 26, and I specialize in sleight of hand and illusions. I've loved magic for forever. When I was a kid, my dad was messing around with cards. I pick one, he pulled it out, and it was my card. I experienced that feeling of like, how did you do that? And I wanted to do that to other people.
Now, say the magic words.
Abracadabra. Oh.
Thank you.
I'm auditioning for Britain's Got Talent because it's the biggest talent show in the world. And I want to be performing on a global scale. And I feel that if it goes well, it can change my life. I'm going to go out on that stage and I'm going to do what I've practiced my whole life, and hopefully they like it.
All right, wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Actually reminds me of a Little Britain sketch that I did. Please, could I have your names?
I'm Paddy.
Yeah, I'm Nico.
And what is the nature of your relationship?
It's a professional one.
And might we ask you your age?
I will be 80 this July.
Do you think you can win the show?
Oh, it would be very nice, but just as long as people enjoy what we're doing and we give people pleasure, that's the main thing.
Okay, well, best of luck.
Thank you.
fastest routine I've ever seen.
For what I did, because I did obviously buzz a little early. This is before all the crazy things happened, you know? It was all kind of like slow and normal, and then it all went ballistic. It was extraordinary.
You're an amazing example to older people, because you've shown that however old you are, you can still be spectacular and beautiful and do something amazing.
She can, all people can. If you want, you can.
How did you get into dancing?
I had been a dancer from the age of 2 and a half, like lots of little girls, and I gave it up to get married. I had 4 children.
Then when did you pick up dancing again?
I went to live in Spain with my husband, and unfortunately, after 18 months, he died. And for something to do, I went to Nico's Dance Academy to learn something totally different, and this is the result.
My grandmother is 93 years old, and I just kept thinking of her when you were being thrown around that man, and I think she would have wanted me to press my buzzer for you as well. So me and my nan are going to be right behind you, and I hope you win Britain's Got Talent. The fact that you did it for all those years and then had your lovely children, then lost your husband, you gave up so much.
Well, when I started to do this, I spoke with the family and I said, what do you think? And they said, well, you gave everything up to have us look after Dad, and he would be proud.
Yes, he would.
Paddy, you are my hero. Like, you are unbelievable. I
pray to God that I am like you when I'm your age. I don't want to sound patronizing, but we have to just say it as it is. That is something I've never seen before. I'm so pleased Amanda has pressed her button. And bravo, Nico.
And do you know what? We don't have to vote.
And if you have a minute, I don't think.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
Good, nice to meet you. What's the act called?
Charlotte and Jonathan.
Charlotte and Jonathan. Okay. How old are you both?
I'm 16.
And I'm 17.
Okay. And you thought the combination would work. Whose idea was it?
It was our singing teacher's, actually. She thought it'd be good to try us out together. And we both sounded quite good when we sang what we did.
Okay, you're not saying much, Jonathan. Are you shy?
Sometimes. I've always had sort of problems with my size since I can remember. And when I was in sort of primary school, it was back then really that I had sort of the mick taken out of me, and it kind of damaged my confidence quite a bit. When people would say something to me, it'd just take a little piece out of me in a sense.
I'm quite protective of Jonathan. Like, if I was there and someone stood there and said something to him, I couldn't sit there with my mouth shut. Before you make a judgment on someone, I think you really need to get to know them. It's not, as cliche as it's not judging a book by its cover. You've got to read what's inside.
Charlotte's been a really big help for me in terms of confidence and making me a better performer. And I really don't think I'd be going up on stage today if I didn't have Charlotte by my side.
And do you think you could win?
Yeah, together.
All right, good luck.
Good luck. Thank you.
Thank you.
Here we go.
That you can move an audience like that. You sing beautifully together. It was world class.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
a pop voice and an opera voice together. It was incredible.
OK, this is what I think. Charlotte, I think you're good, but Jonathan, you are unbelievable. Seriously?
Wow.
You have an outstandingly good voice.
Thank you very much.
How old are you?
17.
I mean, that's unbelievable. Jonathan, you are a future star.
Thank you.
I like the fact that this works as a duo, but I worry, Charlotte, whether you're going to hold him back.
Well, we've come on here as a duo, and we're going to stay here as a duo.
OK, David, we better vote, yes or no? Ah, such an easy decision. Yes.
Thank you.
Definitely a yes from me.
Charlotte, I think your voice complements Jonathan's really well, so don't be disheartened. It's a yes from me.
You know, my head here would say to you, Jonathan, dump her. And then my heart would say there was something kind of magical at moments together as well. So I'm going to say yes to the two of you. You've got four yeses.
Well done! Well done,
Corbin. He's like a young Pavarotti, that boy. I haven't heard a voice like that in years.
No, to be that young and that good.
Simon's a massive fan of you, isn't he?
Seems like it, yeah.
That is the biggest response we've had today.
Well.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Well done, my pal. You think it could be life-changing?
Life-changing? Well, yeah, to be honest.
I think for you.
Yeah.
All right, what's your name, darling?
My name is Susan Boyle.
OK, Susan, and where are you from?
I am from Blackburn, near Bathgate, West Lothian.
It's a big town.
It's a sort of collection of... It's a collection of... villages. I had to think there.
And how old are you, Susan?
I am 47. And that's just one side of me.
Hello?
OK, what's the dream?
I'm trying to be a professional singer.
And why hasn't it worked out so far, Susan?
I've never been given the chance before, but here's hoping it'll change.
OK, and who would you like to be as successful as?
Elaine Page.
Elaine Page.
Like,
what are you going to sing tonight?
I'm going to sing I Dreamed a Dream from the Miserables.
OK. Big song.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by. With their voices soft as thunder.
Sit there.
All right. Thank you very much, Susan Peers.
Without a doubt, that was the biggest surprise I have had in 3 years on this show. When you stood there with that cheeky grin and said, I want to be like Elaine Page, everyone was laughing at you. No one is laughing now. That was stunning, an incredible performance. Amazing. I'm reeling from shock about you two, but...
I am so thrilled because I know that everybody was against you. I honestly think that we were all being very cynical, and I think that's the biggest wake-up call ever. And I just want to say that it was a complete privilege listening to that. It was brilliant.
Oh, Susan, I knew the minute you walked out...
Oh, Simon!
...on that stage that we were going to hear something extraordinary, and I was right.
Quite a lot of touch.
Susan, you are a little tiger, aren't you?
Oh, I don't know about that.
You are? I don't know about that. OK, moment of truth. Here's yes or no.
The biggest yes I have ever given anybody.
Amanda?
Yes, definitely. Brilliant.
Amanda, you too!
Susan Boyle, you can go back to the village with your head held high. It's three yeses.
I think you enjoyed that just a little.
Wouldn't you have?
What a voice.
Incredible.
Congratulations.
Oh, my God.
Congratulations.
Oh, my God.
How do you feel?
Bloody fantastic.
Peter says that's the biggest yes he's ever given on the show. In three series.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Mind-blowing.
Most extraordinary shock we've ever had.
Just so emotional. Unbelievable and emotional and fantastic.